said he's proud of his brother.
It is my pleasure, in the name of a grateful country, to present you with the Distinguished Service Medal for gallant and courageous service above and beyond the call of duty. Adjutant, dismiss the battalion.
Battalion dismissed.
Terry, that was great.
Oh, cut it out. What do you want to do, give me the swell head?
Well, you should have a swell head. Get another medal, you'll sink. How many have you got now?
Too many.
Hello, Jean.
Hello, Terry. Hello, Jim.
Hello, Jean.
Oh, isn't it lovely? I've just written the grandest story about this.
Hold it, folks, hold it.
Now, Terry, you've got to listen to what I've written.
All right.
Lieutenant Terry Kent of the Coast Guard displayed courage, judgment, and resourcefulness in saving hundreds of lives in the face of overwhelming odds. How's that for a front-page story?
If I were your editor, I'd fire you for gross exaggeration.
Say, when do we eat?
That's not a bad idea. Let's eat.
Lieutenant Kent, a message from Commander Boyle, sir.
That's all. Sorry, Jean. My leave's been canceled. I'm due in Commander Boyle's office in 30 minutes. Jim, I'm afraid you'll have to do the honors.
Will I? It's a pleasure.
Hey, what about me?
All right, all right.
Come on, Snapper.
So long, Lieutenant Kent.
Lieutenant Kent? The Air Patrol reports an unregistered private yacht lying off the 12-mile limit. See to it that she doesn't communicate with shore except through authorized channels.
Yes, sir.
There she is. Follow it.
Coast Guard. $500 if you lose that boat.
No use trying to chase them in this fog. What about?
Wait here for me.
You have just had a visual demonstration of what the civilized world considers modern warfare. I'll now give you an idea of what the new disintegration gas will do for the country possessing it. Owing to the limited amount of gas we've been able to manufacture, The demonstration will necessarily be brief. But, gentlemen, it will be sufficient to prove it is of definite value in organized warfare. Watch. The men you see are equipping the plane with several of these specially prepared bombs, the total weight of which is little more than 10 pounds. The plane in the picture could easily carry several hundred times the weight of those few bombs, enough to completely destroy any of the world's largest cities, New York, London, Paris, or Berlin. The disintegration gas is so destructive, it may only be compressed into glass chambers. Behold the power of the disintegrating gas. The entire demonstration took place within 8 minutes.
This disintegration gas looks like the handiwork of Borov. If I didn't have reason to believe Borov dead, I would say he was in back of it.
Were Borov alive, he wouldn't dare show his face in this country. Who is the man behind this?
I'm unable to disclose his identity, gentlemen.
Let it be sufficient to state that the gas is available for your country, should you decide to close the deal.
I'm certain we can come to terms. But my government would feel more confidence if it knew the identity of the man with whom it is dealing.
I'm sorry, I mayn't disclose that.
Explain to us the nature of this disintegration gas.
The gas is radioactive. Its base is the mineral, arnotite.
Arnotite? But arnotite is only found in the United States. One great chemical company owns it. Because arnotite is used so extensively in chemical warfare, the United States government controls its sale or shipment to other countries.
We already possess the supply of arnotite, and we are prepared to smuggle it into your country where the gas can be manufactured.
Ora, no doubt you've heard that the emissaries from Morovania have accepted your proposition.
I shall make preparations to leave at once.
Stock the Napoleon brandy.
I think the occasion demands a toast. Clumsy fool.
This time tomorrow night, we'll find me and the cargo of arnotite bound for Moravania aboard the SS Carfax.
Get below, mister! We're on the run! Lieutenant Kent.
Lieutenant Kent. Yes, sir, at once. I suggest a shore rescue. Yes, sir.
What is it?
Oh, nothing.
Some action.
Yes, but you can't go. Come on, Jim. There's a tramp aground at Cape Dune.
There's the lifeboat! The sea is too heavy! Get up on the bridge and fire a rocket!
Thank you.
Jim. Jim.
This will go to the wreck, discover that the kerosene on board the Carfax is not kerosene, but arnotite, being smuggled to Mauravania. Besides, what about the agreement? Mauravania will expect you to deliver the gas. You've already received money.
Thug would like to cut my throat. Wouldn't you, Thug?
And why shouldn't he? He's never forgiven you for mutilating his mind.
Go ahead, Thug. Cut my throat.
I never saw fear and love, dumb loyalty and consuming hate in such violent opposition in a single human.
Thug isn't human, but he can be very useful.
No one would know you.
I have a great deal to accomplish. The Carfax is going to be investigated tomorrow, and the Arnotite aboard must not be discovered. Here are my plans.
Time, too.
A lot of strain on these, sir.
They'll be all right if another storm doesn't blow up. You men return to the ship. Most of you stay here with me. What are you doing here?
I heard there's to be an inspection of the Carfax the first thing in the morning, and...
And you wanted a scoop for your paper.
If there's a scoop to be had. Perhaps we'll be able to uncover something concerning Borrow.
I'll bring him to justice if it's the last thing I do.
What do you make of it?
It looks like the dredge near Boyer's Wharf, sir.
Sound recall. All hands stand by for fire duty. We'll proceed there at once.
Yes, sir.
That's the recall. I'll have to return to the patrol boat at once.
What does that mean?
Something's up. I won't know till I get there. Certainly not. Stay as long as you like. Take care of yourself.
Take a picture of this? Oh, all right.
Hello. Mister, honest. Now listen, I've got connections.
On the after section. Break out two more lines and bring them to numbers 4 and 6 plugs.
Gene! Gene!
Terry!
Are you all right?